Today we're going to introduce fractions. We're also going to take a look at mixed numbers. So let's start by thinking about a fraction. So what is a fraction? You might think that a fraction is division, and you would be correct. So take a fraction, like for example, 5 over 6. We know that the fraction bar really means division. We also have a numerator. That's what we call the top number. And we call the bottom number the denominator. So when we refer to the numerator and the denominator, that's the numbers that we're talking about. The numerator is the top number, the denominator is the bottom number. But what do fractions mean? What do they represent? So you've likely seen fractions pictured in this manner. So if you have a pie, you can think of it as a pizza, and you have certain parts of that pie. So if we wanted to represent the shaded portion of this pie, well, there are 3 shaded pieces out of a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 pieces. So 3/8 out of this pie is shaded. If we wanted to represent the unshaded portion, well, unshaded, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces. And we'll talk about this a little more later, but if you notice, if you take the 3 shaded pieces and you add to that the 5 shaded pieces, you're going to get a total of 8 pieces. So if you wanted to represent all the pieces, that would be 8 pieces over a total of 8 pieces, which would represent the entire pie. So let's define some terms. Let's define a proper fraction. And the proper fraction is a fraction whose numerator is less than the denominator. And we can easily picture one of those fractions. Say we have this triangle. The triangle is divided into 3 pieces, and 2 of those pieces are shaded. I can represent this fraction, the shaded portion of this triangle, as 2/3. And that is a proper fraction. The numerator is 2, which is less than the denominator. So if we have proper fractions, you might ask yourself, well, what's an improper fraction? And an improper fraction is a fraction whose numerator is greater than or equal to the denominator. And you can picture that as, for example, 3 pies, each of which is divided into 4 sections. And we'll say that in this pie, all the slices are shaded, as well as in this second pie. And on the third pie, only one slice is shaded. So to write this improper fraction, we're to count the number of shaded pieces. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, a total of 9 shaded pieces. That's our numerator. Our denominator will be how many slices each pie is divided into evenly. So each pie has exactly 4 slices. So this is an improper fraction, where the numerator is the number of shaded pieces, and the denominator is the number of pieces that each pie is divided into, so 9/4. A couple of things you might have noticed. When we have a proper fraction, our fraction is going to evaluate to be less than 1. And you can think back to this example over here. We're really representing 2/3 of the triangle. We're not representing the entire triangle. That's why that's 2/3. But in the second example, where we're looking at improper fractions, those are going to evaluate to be greater than or equal to 1. You can think of this as 1 complete pi, 2 complete pies, and a quarter of a third pi. So we call this a mixed number. And we're going to learn that improper fractions can be written as mixed numbers. So let's take a look at that mixed number. So by definition, a mixed number has two components. A mixed number contains a whole number as well as a fraction. And you can look back to our example over here of our mixed number. The 2 would be the whole number component, and the quarter would be the fractional component. And because a mixed number is the same thing as an improper fraction, a mixed number is going to evaluate to be greater than or equal to 1. So let's take a look at another example. Let's go back to the pies. Here we have 2 pies. If we want to write the number of complete pies, well, that's just 1, that's the pie on the left, and we have half of another pie. So that mixed number, 1.5, represents that drawing. Remember, I said improper fractions and mixed numbers are equivalent, so I can also write this as an improper fraction. Our improper fraction, our numerator is just going to be however many shaded pieces we have. We have a total of 1, 2, 3 shaded pieces, so our numerator is 3. And our denominator is going to be what each pie is divided into. So each pie here is divided into 2 slices. So our improper fraction is 3/2. So you should take a second to practice writing improper fractions as mixed numbers and mixed numbers as improper fractions. So let's take a second to look at these drawings. What you should do is you should try to figure out how to represent what's being shown in the drawings as an improper fraction and also as a mixed number. I'll leave that as an exercise for you. And the answers are actually in your textbook. And if you do that, you'll find out that this first drawing, represented as a mixed number, is 2 2/3, but you can also represent it as an improper fraction, and as an improper fraction, it is going to be 8/3. The second drawing can be represented as a mixed number as 1 1/4, and it can also be represented as a mixed fraction as 5/4. Now let's look at how to graph fractions. To graph fractions, we're not really going to learn anything new, except that instead of using pies, we're going to go ahead and use the number line. So the first thing we should do is we should look at the fraction 2/5. And you might ask yourself, what kind of fraction is that? And you'll find out that that's a proper fraction. Recall that a proper fraction has a numerator less than the denominator. So that means that it's going to evaluate to be a number less than 1. So when we graph it, it's going to be somewhere between 0 and 1 on the number line. Okay, now we use the denominator to figure out how many pieces to break up 0 through 1 into. And we're going to break it into 5 pieces. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I'm going to start at 0. We're just going to go however many pieces the numerator says to go. The numerator here says to go 2 pieces. So here's the fraction 2/5. Here are some examples for you to try as well. You should try doing 5/7, 2/3, and 4/6. Try graphing those. Pause the video if you need to. Okay? Just how we can graph proper fractions, we can also graph improper fractions. So let's look, for example, at the fraction 7/6. Well, we know that's an improper fraction because the numerator is greater than the denominator. So we know that it evaluates to be greater than or equal to 1. So that means that when I draw my number line, my fraction is going to be something bigger than 1. I don't know exactly how big yet, but that's okay. We can start with 0, 1, and 2 and increase our number line if we need to. All right? Now I'm going to use the denominator to break up my number line into 6 pieces. So I'll break up 0 through 1 into 6 pieces. So here we have 1 piece, 2 pieces, 3 pieces, 4 pieces, 5 pieces, and the 1 is the 6th piece. I'll do the same thing from 1 to 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Alright, now I'm going to start at 0 and I'm going to count 7 spaces from 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that means that 7/6 is right there. Notice you can also represent 7/6 as a mixed fraction, as a mixed number. 7/6 is all the way up to 1 and then 1/6 of 2. So that's how we get 1 and 1/6 as a mixed number. So you should also go ahead and practice graphing mixed numbers and improper fractions. Try graphing 9/5, 6/6, and 3/1. This last two can be a little tricky. Okay? Now we're going to learn a method for converting mixed numbers to improper fractions and improper fractions to mixed numbers when we don't necessarily have the pictures to look at it. So to convert mixed numbers to improper fractions, we're going to take a couple of steps. We're going to multiply the whole number by the denominator. If you recall, say we have a fraction 1 and 2/3, the 1 is the whole number, the 2 is the numerator, and the 3 would be the denominator. So step 1, we multiply the whole number by the denominator. Then we add our answer from step 1 to the numerator and finally we are going to put our answer from step 2 over the original denominator. So So to show you really quick what that looks like, if I want to convert 1 and 2 thirds to an improper fraction, I'm going to multiply 1 times 3 and add 2 to that, and put all that over the original denominator, which is 3. So 1 times 3 is 3. 3 plus 2 is 5. So 1 and 2 thirds is the same thing as 5 thirds. This would be the mixed number representation of it, and this would be the improper fraction. So you should also practice. I'll give you some problems for you to practice. Write 5 and 2 sevenths as an improper fraction. Write 6 and 2 thirds as an improper fraction. Write 10 and 9 tenths as an improper fraction. And also write 4 and 1 fifth as an improper fraction. So we know how to convert from mixed numbers to improper. You might ask yourself, well, how do I convert from an improper fraction to a mixed number? And what we're going to do is we are going to perform long division on the fraction. But let's recall a couple of things. Let's recall, for example, let's say we want to divide 5 and 3. In long division, that would look like this. Remember, the number on the outside is called a divisor. On the inside, we call that the dividend. And whatever our answer is will be called the quotient. So I'm going to use these terms for the instructions. So step one is just perform long division. Step two is going to say that your quotient will be the whole number portion of the mixed number. Your divisor will be the numerator of the mixed number. And finally, your remainder your divisor will be the denominator, not the numerator. Your remainder will be the numerator. So let's look at converting 5 thirds to a mixed number. So we're going to write it in long division. And 3 goes into 5 once. And we get a remainder of 2. So we go back to our instructions. This 1 will be the whole number portion. This 2 will be our numerator. And this 3 will be our denominator. So our mixed number will look like 1 and 2 thirds. And here are some examples for you to practice. Go ahead and practice converting 23 over 9 to a mixed number, 48 over 4, 62 over 13, 51 over 7, and finally 21 over 20.